the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. On this day, in the morning, we have two incidents that the Lord was going from Bethany to Jerusalem, and on the way, he actually saw the fig tree. And we said that the fig tree specifically, the fruits comes out with the leaves. So when you see the leaves, you expect that it is fruitful. But the Lord went to the fig tree as a man who was hungry and was hungry for love more than food and couldn't find the fruits. So that is why he cursed the tree, the fig tree. He actually didn't curse it for not having fruits, but cursed it for covering that it hasn't got fruits, as if it is deceptive. And this is what we call it hypocrisy. Hypocrisy is to cover bad things or to appear and pretend that you are a different person. Hypocrisy has got pride, and the pride is blind. It makes us not to see. The Lord mentioned that hypocrisy is when we care about the small things and the swallow camels. To take care of what is outside more than what is inside. And to preach and make people to trust that you are great when you are not living really that life. Hypocrisy, the Lord mentioned that it is like tombs painted from outside or filled with filthy things. Probably that what was very important for today, because the Lord is going to talk for more important things. So the most important thing is I am coming to your life, to your temple. He as well cleansed the temple today in the morning. So he is warning us all of life of hypocrisy and the coming into us, our temples, to cleanse us. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit, and he is coming today for us to be cleansed, to clean our lives. And that is very important because he is going today to talk about the second coming. He talked about the narrow gate leading to pure life, pure hearts, and to get rid of our hypocrisy. Are we really having a victory in our lives? Sometimes You want to يعني كده examine yourself. Do we really have hypocrisy? Sometimes. Think about when you are doing something wrong. Do you get very embarrassed? Too much embarrassment? Do you escape immediately when you feel embarrassed from facing anyone? Do you get very embarrassed if you have something wrong in your history and you don't want to talk about it and to hide it? When you go to confession, do you really feel kinda anxious to get everything out gladly that the Lord will take it away, will go to the father of confession very embarrassed and keep saying, I can't really say it. The other thing is taking care of yourself too much. يعني if you keep looking, how long do you spend in front of the mirror every day كده before you go out? How do I look? What is my hair looks like? What my clothes looks like? Like the praise of the others who hate someone to criticize you. That makes us to realize that we have some hypocrisy in our lives. If you have an opinion and someone have different opinion, get very upset and you wanted to prove him wrong and prove you are right. These are just marks kada to examine yourself. But the most important thing is to deal with hypocrisy. How can we deal with hypocrisy? Number one, the Lord, when he said in the beginning of fasting, fast, pray, give alms, he said one thing in the three of them, do it what? Secretly, hiddenly. Do it for your Father up in heaven. Be careful always to deal with God, not with people. Whatever you say, as if you are saying in front of God. Whatever you do, do it for God, in His presence. If you live in His presence, you will never be hypocrite. If someone is criticizing you or humiliating even you, how do you take it? The Bible tells us, rejoice. Blessed are you when they, when they give you tribulation, they mock you, they humiliate you for me. Self-examination every day. Don't go to sleep unless you revise kada what you have done on that day. If you upset someone, go and reconcile. If you have done something wrong, apologize. If you have done something good, ask the Lord to help you to do more. Yeah. And when you go to confession, be very clear and blunt. Don't decorate what you have done. Many people come to say, for example, I am sorry, Abuna, I really have lied, but the person who I was talking to him was horrible. So you are giving what? Excuses for lying. Don't please give excuses for yourself. Today, the Lord is preparing us for His second coming. And to prepare us for to be judged here before we stand before the last day judgment. يعني اعتبر confession is a mock judgment. With self-examination every day is a mock judgment. مش بتعملوا mock exams كده قبل الexams؟ Yeah. فموك judgment كده every day وموك judgment في الconfession to make sure when you stand before the Lord in the last day it will pass. Please, it is the Lord a commandment for us to pray and watch. To be ready for this last or second coming. May our Lord give us all to be honest, open hearts, open minds, and cleansed every single day. Cleansed every single day. May the Lord give us to complete this holy Pascha week and accompany Him in His footsteps, step by step, so that we can connect with Him. The Lord today wants us to feel for Him. Whatever He does, he is doing it for you. Accompany Him, connect to Him, and feel that on the Thursday, when He will have the Holy Communion, He will take the bread on His hands and break it and pray and say, this is my body. What is that bread? What is that bread? Us. It is us. يعني He is preparing us to be changed into Him. To be one with Him. To be His own flesh and blood. That is why the Bible said for us all, we are members in His body. And we are participants in the divine nature of God. If you really want to be like that, you have to be pure. عارفين أبونا كده ما يدخل يبارك البيت to bless your home, he says what? Houses of prayers, houses of purity, houses of blessings. And the main blessing is that we are changing our lives to be His life. May the Lord give us all the great grace. Glory to God forever.